Hey guys, welcome back to a new episode of Delhi Passenger Responsible Travel Podcast. We didn't even notice that 6 months of 2020 have passed in such a weird style that no one had expected. If in January you had told me that all my travel plans will be cancelled and we will be sitting at home, then I would have called you a stupid person and I would have shown you tickets of all the places that I was planning to travel. Before we start today's episode, I would like to share something with all the aspiring writers out there. All of us need expert help when it comes to writing effectively. Samapita Mukherjee Sharma is a veteran writer and an industry leader. She has launched a new book, How to Write a Story Effectively, and it is now available on Amazon Kindle. So look it up and purchase the book. It will sure help you start working on that story that you always wanted to write but didn't know how to start.
Our guest for today is a runner, a mountaineer, and one of the leaders in the global waste management movement. He is the person who introduced me to the campaign of Cleaning Himalayas, and we have done multiple projects together. So without further ado, I always wanted to use this phrase. So without further ado, I would like to introduce you with my guest. It is Avinash Pratap Singh. I'd like to thank him for taking out his time for the session. Before we start today's episode, I hope you guys are subscribed to the podcast on the platforms where you are listening. Hi Avinash, how are you?
Hi, Anshul, thank you for inviting me to your podcast and good to be here.
So Avinash, please share a little about your professional background.
Anshul and everyone, whoever is listening to this podcast, my name is Avinash and I'm the CEO of Waste Warriors. Waste Warriors is a small non-profit organization working in Dehradun, Dharamshala, Corbett, and trying to keep the mountains, the jungles, and our cities clean by community-led action. I myself come from a rural background and then went for an engineering. After that, I fell in love with mountains and I run a little bit, not many more at this, but I used to, and that's how I got into Dharamshala project at first. Being in the mountains, just cleaning up, and that was a very satisfying time. Today, we are much more than cleaning up mountains. We are into advocacy, we are into recycling, and we work with world's leading companies and organizations to fight the war against climate change.
What is your personal style of traveling? Like, how do you like to explore a place, introduce yourself to a new destination? How do you do it?
So, Anshul, personally, I end up traveling to a place where I already have a contact. Most of the time, that's how it happens, that I'm going to a village where I had met a pradhan or a hiker guide who lives there, and I go to live there with their family or village or something like that. Other than that, I personally like to travel through my motorbike these days. Before that, I was also traveling by public transport and possibly just hitchhiking sometimes. So I want to have more freedom when I travel in terms of where I want to stop, who I want to stay with, what I want to eat, and then link it with whatever local aspect of region I am traveling to. If it's a seaside, then maybe go help a local guide with a business by learning, I don't know, surfing from him, even if I don't know how to surf. If I'm going to the mountains, I try to spend time with someone who I have met during my mountaineering course or during any of my volunteering initiatives. So that's how I like to travel mostly, without having major dependency on a certain plan. And as well as I try to stay, I would try to call myself a budget traveler mostly. I don't like to travel which costs me tons and tons, because travel is not about how much money you spend. Travel is about who you meet, what memories you build, and what you saw, and how you experienced.
We all have been exposed to Himalayas through Himachal Pradesh or little bit of Uttarakhand. Avinash, I met Avinash during my trip to Dharamshala, and that's how I ended up volunteering with Waste Warriors for the first time. Before that, Avinash had already climbed a couple of mountains, did a couple of marathons in this region. So, Avinash, how about you tell us about your journey in Himalayas, like since the
That's a very interesting question, Anshul. So, it's very incidental how I got in touch with Jodi and the Hill to volunteer at Waste Warriors Dharamshala project. I was just scrolling through a page where people register for races, and another racer contacted me saying that she wants me to help her train for races. And when I further talked to her, I explored and I found out that there's this British lady climbing a mountain and training up trails in Mani Mahesh and Dharamshala and adjoining regions. So it was very interesting for me that someone from abroad has come and trying to keep our mountain clean. And mountains being far away, like, it's our human instinct that we get attached to things which we don't find that close. So I wrote to her and I said, I want to come volunteer with you. And I went there for 3 days. I stayed back 10 days in Dharamshala, spending time cleaning up waterfall and mountains and tombs and all those places. That was my first interaction with Jodi, as well as the whole volunteer-based tourism, or spending time to clean up a mountain and not having much of a broader picture thought that, okay, we will do our part of the karma and we will clean it up. And that will help other people envision how a clean trail looks like. So that was my first interaction. And after that, I just fell in love with the mountains. I went for my basic mountaineering course with Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. Then climbed a couple of higher unknown mountains in the Dharshula region. Did hikings in like regular routes as well, like Rupkund or Indrahar Pass or some trails near Shimla. I hiked in Kaza. So it all started with a small initiative or small choice of going to closely engage myself in a mountaineering initiative, which opened the door to further learn more about mountains and how one can live in mountains or build a hobby around hiking or cycling. When I say cycling, it's basically mountain biking and things like that. And that exposure has started a journey in the Himalayan region, and I hope to have many more experiences there.
Since the lockdown has happened, waste management industry has almost taken a pause. So how are you and your team responding to this situation, and how it has impacted your ability to conduct cleaning operations and waste segregation?
This is a very important question, Anshul. Thank you for asking this. Actually, I would rephrase it, and I would say that the modality of waste management operations has changed, but the waste management word has not really paused, because we haven't stopped consuming.
Yes.
So as long as we consume, the need of waste management will always be there. When the lockdown happened, Waste Warriors has to quickly evolve into how it manages waste and how it conducts the cleaning operations. All our gathering-based cleanup, where group of volunteers or group of individuals come to clean up, does not happen anymore at this specific stage, but everything else in terms of collection, recycling, segregation awareness, all of that continues. For example, everything which we are doing one-to-one earlier now has moved to more like a WhatsApp or virtual learning session. So we have been organizing webinars about how to segregate the waste or how to segregate dry recyclables from wet and how to compost. We ran WhatsApp related campaigns to over 70 WhatsApp groups we manage in Dehradun, Dharamshala and Corbett. And we also provided waste collection to people who are segregating even through the lockdown. So we got special permissions from the government to run the operation when the lockdown was happening.
How are you preparing yourself and your team to conduct your operations in a post-lockdown world, especially when the people will start traveling again?
I was actually part of another discussion on a similar topic, Anshul. The discussion revolves around how travelers' behavior is going to change when they start traveling post-lockdown. My understanding is that when the world opens up, there will be a little more sensitivity towards the nature and towards our behavior when we start going out again. I expect people to take care of their waste and their surrounding and their action and its impact on nature a little more when they start traveling again and start valuing the nature and the environment we are blessed with in the country. We plan to resume our waste related awareness engagement when the world opens to traveling again. And at the same time, we also want to empower more and more local people to take care of waste awareness or waste management in the mountains, like tea shop owners or hikers who lead hikes, or you can call them guides or tour operators, so that the need of us being at the mountain top reduces.
So now that we are already talking about travel, so please share something about your experience with volunteer travel and how other travelers can benefit from it.
I think volunteer travel, Anshul, is a very nice idea, whoever brought it. Now people actually fancily call it voluntourism.
Yeah.
So I think Waste Warriors specifically got benefited by this volunteer-based tourism a lot in the very beginning when we had a shortage of hands in our cleaning operations in Dharamshala. And even today, more than 1,000 people come to our cleanups in a year throughout the country, wherever we organize these kind of cleanups. In Dharamshala, Dehradun, Corbett, or sometimes even beyond our sea operations area. I think the volunteers in either waste management segment or education or farming would keep playing a very active role in building the culture of giving back while traveling to a new geography. And I believe that even when the lockdown is going to be lifted off, people will bring their values to different programs when they come to volunteer while touring across the country.
Right, right. I agree. Even I have benefited a lot from volunteer travel, volunteerism, that people are calling it now. Yeah.
Yes, it's a very, very good platform for creating an exchange of ideas or cultures, depending on where you come from. Especially when you are in India, even if we are in from the same country, if we come from a different district or different state, it's already the two different cultures.
Right. Why do you think more young Indian travelers who are in their 20s, not like past 25 or something, should consider volunteer traveling instead of following the usual itineraries?
Anshul, the answer to this is very straightforward actually. The same idea which is behind volunteering should be taken forward in the tourism as well. We need to think why people travel.
Mm-hmm.
Some people travel to experience a different landscape. Some
right.
people travel to experience a specific heritage,
mm-hmm.
or some people travel to experience culture.
Mm-hmm.
Most of these reasonings behind the travel gets absorbed when you go to travel, when you go to volunteer to a new organization or new place. Actually, the volunteering adds even more value to your actual reason or logic behind traveling, because then you get to see whatever you are planning to see from a local's eye or local side, you can say it simply. So I think the youth of the country should choose to travel through volunteering and to by visiting local organization and not just follow a fixed itinerary as a tourist, because that would benefit them as well as local organizations when they visit those places.
And lastly, I would like to know, what is your definition of a responsible travel in a very holistic sense?
I think, Anshul, the word responsible tourism is a very, very, very broad word.
Yeah.
So it covers, I would say that it covers 3 to 4 main components when you travel and you want to be a responsible traveler. You first have to figure out your carbon footprint or your travel's impact on environment. Now, the carbon footprint or your travel's impact on environment could be in multiple ways. One is basically how you travel, either you fly or take a train or cycle or walk or whatever you choose to opt for. But in all through these things, you have to compare how responsible can you become, and depending on how strict you are in terms of responsible tourism, you can follow it. Similarly, it's about waste generation. What kind of products you use while traveling? Do you have your own straw? Do you have your own bottle? All of these things form one component where we call it an environmental impact of your travel. That's one component of your responsible travel. The other is mostly the social impact. So by your travel, did you manage to impact the society wherever you are traveling? Either it's by sharing the culture or trying to live more through the local customs, respecting local customs. That's the social impact of your travel. So a responsible tourism or a responsible tourist should cover that component of the social side of your travel. How does it impact? The third one, which is mostly very important in responsible tourism, is the economic impact of your travel. So when you are traveling, are you buying local? Are you staying at home stays? Are you contributing to local farm or local business? All these actions lead to the economic impact of your travel. And that's why that is the third major important component of your tourism. So a social, socially, environmentally, and economically conscious person can become a responsible tourism through taking care of your actions, which lead to these kind of impact in these key reasons.
With this, we come to the end of this episode. Thank you, Avinash, for being with us and for sharing his valuable insights with our listeners.
Thank you, Anshul. Thank you for inviting me on your podcast. Everyone, whoever is listening to the podcast, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay positive. You will get to travel again soon. Travel responsibly and volunteer with anyone, whoever you are traveling. That's a good way to travel.
If you like the interview, then please subscribe to the podcast on whichever platform you are listening it. And do share your suggestions about future topics. You can connect with me on Instagram as hunting_bachelor and with Avinash at
either Facebook or any other social media platform. It's just Avinash B.Singh.
Or you can also follow the regular updates on Waste Warrior social media channel to know more about volunteering and plastic free life and everything in general.
Thank you, Anshul.
Thank you, Avinash.